crucifixion. The Kirkin, and I want to share with some of us, the visitors here, a little bit about the history of the Kirkin and what happened after the Battle of Culloden on April 16, 1746. The English Parliament banned the wearing of tartan, speaking Gaelic, Scottish music, dancing, or playing the pipes. Any person caught doing any of these could be shot on sight, arrested, or exiled to the colonies. This ban lasted for 36 years. Legend says that the Highlanders devised a plan to hide a piece of tartan in their clothing during church. At a set time during the service, they would hold the tartan and bless it. When the Scots were forced to fight for the British army, it is said that the women would take a piece of their tartan to the kirk to be blessed and to pray for the protection of their clan. Thus came the Scottish celebration known as the Kirkin of the Tartan. The first Kirkin in the United States was held in April 1941 by Scottish-born chaplain of the U.S. Senate, Dr. Peter Marshall, who was a minister of the New York Avenue Presbyterian Church in Washington, D.C. to encourage Scottish Americans to sign up to fight in the war, in World War II, on behalf of Great Britain. Dr. Marshall attempted to instill pride among Scottish Americans and their Scottish homeland. The idea for the Kirkin of the Tartan soon spread, and the ceremony is now held in churches across the U.S. everywhere, even in Canada and across the rest of the world. There's something about Scottish and Irish pride. You just can't beat it. What we're going to do, as the pipes and drums band plays, and I want to, while I have a chance, thank them so much for being a part of this, the Shining Fishers. I am going to ask that the clan's reps would come and lay their tartans up on this stage here. And Reverend Saunders is going to pray the blessing of the tartan over them. After you are seated, he will pray the blessing of the tartan over them. So as they play, please proceed forward. Thank you.
shall we? On behalf of all Scots and Irish away from Scotland and Ireland, and in the name of all the Scottish and Irish clan folk that are here represented, we pray and present these tartans before you, Almighty God. In appreciation of our heritage, we ask you, Lord, for your blessings upon the families that are represented by these tartans. Lord, I ask you and I beg you, Father, Lord, that you will meet with your servants and bless them and fulfill now thy promise and make us joyful in our prayer, so that our worship being offered in thy name of thy Son Jesus Christ, by the guidance of thy Holy Spirit, may be acceptable unto you and profitable unto ourselves. Bless, we pray, these tartans, that they may be unto us and to all the people a token of the faith of our fathers and a sign of our service unto you. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
We're going to close with a hymn and prayer. When I was thinking about what hymn for us to close with, I wanted to honor Clan Kian a little bit. And many of us, if you ever listen to gospel music or something, have heard of this hymn. You go, well, that's not very Scottish or Irish. Actually, it is. Joseph Scriven, who wrote this particular hymn, was born in Ireland. And one day he watched them pull his fiancée, who he was going to marry the next day, out of the lake. And she had drowned. And so he, after a while, built some strength back up within him, and he said, I'm going to move to the Americas, and I'm going to start a new life. Wound up in Canada. And while he's there, his mom sent him a letter back over from Ireland and was telling about all the hardships and troubles was happening in Ireland at that time. And so he wrote her this poem. And she was so moved and touched by it that she gave it to the publisher, and they put music to it, and it became the number one hymn at that time in Europe, and then eventually in America. When it first came out in Europe, it was author unknown. When it came to America, he was sitting at a service and heard this hymn being sung. He said, wait a minute, that's my song. And so, but later on in life, he got fell in love again and was going to be married, and his fiance again, his new fiance, caught typhoid fever and died. So instead of just kicking himself while he's down, he decided to serve others. And in Canada, he's considered a great servant to the church. And he lived his whole life serving others, decided to help widows, help the poor, help the homeless. And so, like Reverend Saunders was saying this morning, you know, you can get a Scotsman down, you can get an Irishman down, but you can't keep him there. So I'm going to ask if you would stand, and let's sing this hymn together.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Everything to God in prayer.
For each clan, each person represented here today. Once again, we want to thank you for our Scottish and our Irish heritage that you have blessed us with. We want to thank you for this great nation that we live in today. Father, I want to pray for our troops as they are overseas fighting, as many are in the fire and harm's way. Father, we ask your protection upon them. We pray for the men and women that are serving in the military, Father. We hold them to your throne and ask that you would keep them.
Yes.
We pray for the spouses that are here at home and their families. We ask that you protect them, bless them, keep them, provide for their every need. We thank you for the freedoms that we have here in this nation. We are blessed. And I thank you for each person here. And as we go about these games today, may your blessing be upon us. May a smile be upon our face, and we thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.